Okay, well, apparently this won't work unless I hit the play button. So, sorry, first time doing Facebook Live. Started like 10 minutes ago, but like I said, I didn't hit the play or record or the live button. So here we go. Doing the blob because this guy popped up everywhere the last couple of days, like every post on this group, on Masterpieces, on the Sketch Traders group. Like every other post is about the blob. So here, that's what I decided to do. I don't know how long one of these videos can last. Hopefully, it's longer than 15 minutes, because it will take longer than that, but I'm also gonna try to save the video if I figure out how to do that at the end and repost. I can't remember which, let's see if this makes a difference. Nope. Can't remember which member was the one that's I used the word obsessed with this guy, but I'm not sure if to thank you or hate you for the blob apocalypse of posts. So if people like this type of stuff, and this is something that you guys want to see in the group, I have a lot of free time lately, so I'll probably do this again. I don't know at what frequency, but I could probably bang out one of these once a week. I've been spending the bulk of my free time working on the insert set for a set that we're not allowed to talk about that may or may not be released in 20. Hint, hint, nudge, nudge. Been spending way too long on any on all those cards, but I don't mind. I look at it as a great learning experience. If my Joker math is right by the time I'm done those 100 sketch inserts, I will have about 350 hours banked on acrylic painting. It's really a medium that's pretty new to me. So even looking through the cards, the first few cards that I did when I got the shipment versus the one, for example, the one that I finished last night, I can see a significant improvement in technique and brush control and the way I'm getting accustomed to the medium. So the way I look at it, it's like homework. So I really have no issue spending 3 hours on a sketch card if I have the time to do so. Base insert or, well, of course, APs. I would spend longer on APs. But I don't know how chat works in Facebook Live, but if somebody, I don't know if anyone's got any questions or anything. Well, I guess you can't actually put out your question. Oh, you can type it. I see there's a little comment panel. Or not. Doesn't really, so it's Thursday, and I think the podcast comes out today. I didn't get a notice yet in my app, so maybe it's delayed. I don't know, or maybe Ian's sleeping in. I don't know. I'm just speculating. Oh, Jonathan, you expected silk? You know, I was kind of planning out the next few cards. To do for the set, and it's gonna go into what the characters I've done so far, and yeah, there's, I have to admit, there's a shortage of silk, so I actually had to start making a list of characters I want to make sure I cover. yep, Silk will be there at least once. Well, there'll be a Silk for you to chase if you are so inclined. This dude right here, he's gonna have a presence in my next set. Now that I think about it, this sketch here, which is a little tighter than I usually would do for as a prelim for a sketch card, might evolve into a sketch card. This guy will have, from my end anyways, probably three instances, maybe. So I can either confirm or deny that. Something's wrong here. The video freeze? No. Take note and turn off all my notifications next time I do one of these, because I don't need all the dinging of my emails and text messages coming in. I'm sure they're coming through the audio. is lovely elevator music. Some of these guidelines. So I'm not too familiar with this character. I'm kind of looking at some of his images on Google. For the most part, especially in the Liefeld area, he seems to have like one of those Three Stooges haircuts, which I'm not really loving. Kind of looks like a stooge. That kind of bowl cut. I don't know what it is. Like that, with the teeny tiny beady eyes. That. I don't like that. So, gonna kind of winging the hair. So I'm working on 5x7 size. I've started doing this lately on most sketches I do. And it's really the sketch card aspect ratio. Right, 5x7 is 2.5x3.5x doubled. And the only reason I've been doing that now, or recently, is I'm planning on getting back into digital at some point, once into digital art is, once things come down a little bit or clear up my schedule a bit, and I'm thinking of sorry, the video paused there for a second. I'm not sure what happened. I'm working 5x7 because I'm going digital, and I was thinking of maybe doing my own set. Or if not my own set, kind of doing business cards that are sketch card size. And printing them, printing original art on them. So if I work at this size, once it's scanned to Photoshop, it scales perfectly down to sketch card size, and I'll be able to use it. There was a point too that I was gonna make, but I totally forgot. Oops. It's also a comfortable size because it fits well, 8.5x11. Gives me enough room to futz around for if I paint it without having an edge. So it gives me enough. I like to have a little bit of extra space to work with, and then I always put the crop marks, so where it's going to crop. So if I do end up painting it, I can paint outside of guides and then trim it to this size. And anyone who's ever gotten a an AP commission for me that chose to see the process, I would have seen a prelim sketch of their card at this size. And the way I work with APs, pretty much all APs and some insert cards, is I'll do the sketch at this size. That way, scan Photoshop, scale it down, tweak it a little bit. Also gives me a lot more space to build out detail and work out things. Like trying to do the teeth at this level of teeth at normal sketch card size is a real pain. I have to work with a 0.3 mil pencil, and the lead keeps on snapping on that. But if I do this way, take it to Photoshop, adjust it as needed, kind of move the arms around before if I mess up the scale, print that out, and then do a carbon transfer onto the actual sketch card, and all the details there, and takes a lot of the thinking out of it. Also allows me to make a very clean sketch card, because you don't end up with any with too many sketch lines you have to clean up after. And what I found is, with the material on some of the sketch cards, the paper stock is kind of crap. The Premiere masterpieces, or any of the ones that are nice and thick, those are a little bit more forgiving by your standard sets, like Infinity War, Far From Home, Endgame, those 18-point cards. I found anyways, as you erase and work the surface, it starts wearing down. So then when I go to apply ink or paint, it bleeds a lot more because the surface is stretched, or you're starting to really kind of take that initial initial coating of whatever they put on the cards off, and it just makes it really hard to work with the cards. So if I don't need to really erase much or worry too much about, or I end up not having a lot of sketch lines on the actual card I need to erase, usually what I end up doing is just doing carbon transfer, clean pencil lines, and boom, go right in with paint or occasionally ink, and it works a lot better. Doesn't always work as planned, but that's the idea anyways. So like I said before, I'm not too familiar with this character, so I don't know exactly how many chins he's supposed to have. Hey Jason, thanks for popping in. Oh, yes, Jonathan, you are missing a lot. I'm talking. I figured out how to work the chat. So you also see the, I have my computers up here. I can see the messages come up on my screen, so I'll go and respond every now and then. This maybe was not the best time of day to do it. I decided to do this around noon my time. I'm in Toronto, Canada, so that's EST. But it looks like a lot of you guys are actually working and watching this without sound or zoning in and out. Somebody said that they have to talk to their tax broker. It's like Jonathan is at work, but oh, like I said, if there's a, I'm not looking for a large response, but if you guys like this and this kind of content is something that the group is okay with having posted there, I'll definitely do this again. I used to do this on my YouTube channel a lot, but then I stopped because life got in the way. Then occasionally I'll do it on Instagram, but I haven't been too active there lately either, just busy with other stuff. But I do like to record my process, whether video or just stills throughout the various stages of the drawing or painting, just so I can look back on it later and see where I made mistakes, see where things worked really well, and just learn from it. Sure how long I'm allowed to keep this going, but I have probably another half hour before I have to actually get some work done. So I'll keep at it, see how far I can take this. It's gonna start blocking in some of the shadow areas. Almost feel like I should look up some reference of baby hands for to get the scale. Well, not the scale, the proportions of proper hands for the blob. Okay, he really shouldn't have a very well-defined peck region. I don't know if there's a way on Facebook to have multiple streams in one video, but that would be cool if maybe we can get a couple of sketch card artists in one stream to kind of work on the same theme at the same time. Maybe it's not the right platform for me to do that with a Zoom. I'll reach out to a couple of people that I think might be up for it. I think that would be something really cool. Be really cool if you can get Joe Jusco or his name escapes me now. Bianchi. Hopefully pronouncing that right. Freddie Yen. Some of those guys in on the action. That'd be fun. missing any comments?
Nope.
Trying to make a makeshift stump out of some scrap paper, but it's not going to work. Thank you. Oh, right. Wow. Segway. So, like half an hour ago, I was talking about working at 5x7 so I can scan these, take them to Photoshop, and do some digital painting. Because I was thinking of printing out my own cards or business cards. So, I did a test run with some other portrait sketches. And this is what the print looks like. This is satin finish, 18 points, got a nice thickness to it. So yeah, I might do some of these further down the road, if nothing else, just to throw in with orders of APs or just hand out if I'm at conventions or chatting with people, kind of like business cards. But yeah, like this with some branding, because otherwise this is just useless. That was a print test. Because I'm getting older, I'm starting to get a little forgetful. Pretty safe to say I'm not finishing this on the live stream. There's just not enough time. Like I said earlier, this is the first time I'm doing one of these live streams, and I may have or I may need to plan better in the future. Like last time I did a full stream, I think I did 3 hours on master study of Rosetta. Actually, that's here somewhere. That is nowhere near finished. Probably not the same audience, but was it this one? It was this guy. That eventually I'll come back to, but not anytime soon. I have a stack of passion projects that I wanted to work on and complete, and was hoping that the outbreak will be a good opportunity for it. But turns out I don't have quite as much free time as I thought I would, which is good, because then I'm having some clients that are still operating. So having some proper consulting work is good. But this isn't a pitch for my day job, so we'll talk about that anymore. Hey man, yeah. It's all blob all the time, everywhere. All he sees is the blob, or all I see is the blob. Getting blob vision, so bam, blob. That's his name, Rodney. Yes, he's, I don't know who this Rodney character is. He popped up out of nowhere and he's just blobbing everywhere. I love it. I commented on a post saying that the guys at Marvel and Upper Deck aren't gonna know what happened once the next set comes out, and there's gonna be an influx of blob sketches coming in from artists, and they're not going to know what happened or why. They're going to start running models and performers, try to figure out why the character popped, try to talk to all their product licensees and licensors to create more Blob merchandise. You're going to see Blob t-shirts at Walmart, and the kids are going to be all confused. It's going to be awesome. Can't wait. So, thanks for that, Rodney. Is Rodney here? Maybe he'll catch this later. Oh, okay, yeah. I'm only gonna be on for like another 10-15 minutes, but if he's the Blob guy, let's get him in on the action. Maybe you can tell me how many chins he's supposed to have. Who's Jeff? Matt. Man, hi Jeff. Oh, okay. Well, hello, Jeff. That Jeff. All right. Alright, well, it looks like the first 10 minutes of this video ended up being live streamed on one of my clients' accounts. Just got a message asking WTF. Oops. Awesome. Oh, blow cleavage shading. Yeah, that's where we are, people. You know, you've been cooped up inside too long when. Of course, to blob cleavage, that's, yeah, man, it's obvious. I'm surprised more people haven't decided to pursue a career in the arts for this reason alone. Let me hop on Twitch and you know, I'm sure Jim Lee, if you ask him, this is exactly why he did it. Oh, Jonathan, the chicken grease. Yeah, Jonathan, I have, yeah, I'm not touching that. Though that's a market that I actually consider trying to break into. But then I decided that it's probably not where I want to be. It's one of those things that if, you know, if one of my clients sees this, blob cleavage and all, they're gonna be like, okay, that's cool, interesting, whatever. If they were to somehow stumble across some of that other type of work, that would not end well. Though it might be quite lucrative, so I don't know. It's different, Matt. There's blob cleavage here. This is, it's like the difference between dolls and action figures. Oh, yeah, you're right, Jonathan. It does actually look like Mojo. Totally coincidental. It's the smile. Yeah. Think there's a lot of similarities between the Blob and Mojo from a design standpoint. Think the Blob has some of their skin. You must moisturize. Chicken oil. Get this done, but it doesn't look like I have the time. Shoot, guys, thanks for joining. Thanks for the comments. I hope you enjoyed this. Hopefully, I can post it for others to watch later, or if Jonathan, for you to watch with sound. Or at least save it to my phone so I can post it onto YouTube. Yeah, obviously it's not getting done. It's pretty close. If this is something that you guys enjoyed and don't mind seeing directly in the feed for the group, I will definitely do this again, except maybe I can get some other people in on it. Maybe other people will do it as well. If not, DM me. I do this stuff on Instagram or on YouTube occasionally, so I can do that. I'm not looking to build followers or audiences or whatever. If you guys can get some enjoyment out of watching me doodle, that's great. If not, that's great as well. Yeah, that's it. This is the Blob for now. I'm gonna get on some calls, do some work. Let's see there. I'll try to maybe just finish up this side later today, and I'll post the final picture. Oh, coloring stage. Yeah, if I were to color this, I wouldn't shade to this detail because it's just overkill. But yeah, you know what? Maybe next time I'll do a painting, or at least part of a painting. Anyways, let me know. Post in the messages, so on. That's it. Thanks, guys. Have a good one.